This is part one of a three-part video showing how I painted this Space Marine Captain. So I'll start with a black base coat. For this I just used Vallejo Surface Primer Black, and I just put this on with a paintbrush. You can use an airbrush or a paintbrush, it doesn't really matter. As long as it goes on smoothly, that is. For the base coat, I'm using Vallejo Game Color Imperial Blue. So once I've got the base coat down, I'll start adding in the shadows, and for this I just mix up a glaze of 50-50 Imperial Blue and Black. And I'm just going to put this in the darkest areas. So once I finish with the shadows, I start bringing out the highlights using a 50-50 mix of Imperial Blue and Ultramarine Blue. And this is just a very thin mix of paint, and I'm just adding it on very slowly so that I can get a smooth transition between dark and light. So when you're glazing like this, it's good practice to move your brush in the direction of the lightest areas. This is because when you lift your paintbrush off, that's where most of the pigment is left behind. For these highlights, I'm mixing through from Imperial Blue through to Ultramarine Blue, and for the highest highlights I'm going to be using Electric Blue. These are all Vallejo paints. So here I start glazing with the mid-tone to smooth out the transitions between the shadows and the highlights. The more you do this, the smoother the transition is going to look and the better the result will be. So after a bit more highlighting, this is the end result. Here I'm actually using a slightly different technique. This is called the loaded brush technique. Now you do this technique by making a glaze of the medium tone, or the darker tone of the two, and then you take a very small amount of the highlight colour that you want and put that on the very tip of the brush, and then you start from the highest point and blend in one movement from the highest point to the darkest point. And I also add in a little bit of edge highlighting too. I'm also using the loaded brush technique on the knee. I like this technique because you can get very good results quickly once you become comfortable with it. The good thing about the loaded brush technique is if you don't get it right first time, you can come in and do the same thing over the top for a better result. So at this point, I'm done with the blue. I also did the arm, but I didn't record it, just in the interest of keeping the video a little bit shorter. So now I'm starting work on the gold parts of the model, and for this I'm using a non-metallic metal technique. If you don't know what that is, it basically means you use brown paint instead of gold paint to imitate the metallic look. And worst case scenario, if you mess up your non-metallic metals, then your metals will just look brown instead of gold, so it's not the end of the world. So similarly to any other sort of highlighting, I'm just taking a slightly lighter colour than before and placing it in the areas that are going to be brighter. The main difference between non-metallic metals and any other sort of highlighting is that the non-metallic metal colours are basically going to be a lot more contrasting. Your darks are going to be a lot darker and your brights are going to be a lot brighter. And that's how you get the metallic look. So for these highlights, I'm adding in more and more yellow to the mix. The yellow that I like to use is Vallejo Game Color Moon Yellow. So the highlights are getting quite bright now. I'm just working my way up to a highlight of pure moon yellow, and then once I've done that one, I can add in white to the mix. And now I'm just adding an extra little glaze of a mix between dark fleshtone and black, just for some extra shadows. I did the emblem on the leg in the exact same way that I did the chest. In hindsight, I reckon I could have used a little less white, but I think it came out alright in the end. So I think I'm going to call that part one of the video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. And make sure to subscribe if you want to see more. You can also find me on Instagram. Thanks for watching.